Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Antelope Valley College Performing Arts Theater for today's Vocational Nursing Pinning Ceremony. A few items prior to the start of the pinning. Please note the fire exits are located on the left and right of the theater, as well as the rear of the theater. No photography or videography is allowed during today's pinning. No food or drink is allowed in the theater except for bottled water. Again, thank you for joining us for today's ceremony and enjoy the day.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the Vocational Nursing Program for 2022. Let's all give them a round of applause. We have several faculty and administrators here, and several are going to speak with you. We have Candy Martin, Linda Parkinson, Mary Jacobs, Susie Snyder. They worked really hard with the graduates to get them to where they are today. I hope that you enjoy this event that celebrates the achievements of these amazing individuals. First, from the administration, we have Greg Borman. We also have VP of Academic Affairs, Howard Davis. And our new president of the college, Dr. Jennifer Zullett. And now Greg Borman has a few words.
Good afternoon. Welcome on, say happy time, Mr. Super Bowl. Good afternoon. Much better, much better. My name is Greg Borman. I'm the dean of career technical education here at Antelope Valley College. I'd like to welcome you on behalf of the institution, the board, the president, faculty, staff, and of course your loved ones. The amount of time and effort they put into the program and the job they've chosen to do warrants a lot of respect, in my opinion. To choose a life of service, to do what they do, I've seen it. I've seen a little emotional about it. I haven't seen what they do in the hospitals. I think it's very commendable. And congratulations. Give yourselves a round of applause. And at this time, I would like to introduce our president, Dr. Jennifer Zullett, to come up and say a few words. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is a really happy occasion, and all of you should be so proud to be here. Graduates, you should be very, very proud. You've chosen to do a very hard thing. You've chosen to persist in your education in a time when the world is absolutely upside down. And I've been on this campus for 38 days, so I haven't had the privilege yet of meeting the graduates personally, but here's what I already know about them. I know they are trustworthy people, and I know that they are kind. And how do I know that? This is how I know that. No one goes into a helper profession unless they have a kind spirit. And nobody is worthy of trust unless they have character and competence. And by virtue of the fact that they're sitting on this stage today, they've demonstrated some competence. They've learned a lot. They've learned the skills of their profession, and they're ready to demonstrate that. And by their kindness and their willingness to serve, particularly in a time when people are leaving healthcare professions because it's so hard, they're stepping up to do the hard thing. So that tells me that they are people of character. So when you combine character and competence, you have a person who is trustworthy. And I'm so very proud to call them Antelope Valley College alumni. Today is also about all of you, because no person is an island. No person accomplishes anything by herself or himself. We all have our some people call them balcony people. They sit up there in the balcony and they cheer you on when you think you can't get up and do one more day of study. You can't take one more test. You can't go to work one more time. You're just too spent. You have your balcony people who sometimes are cheering and sometimes are saying, if you don't get yourself out and go to class, right? But those are balcony people too. All of you have made this possible because you've supported them in their learning. And so graduates, now's your chance to say thank you, and you can all give each other a round of applause as well. You deserve the thanks. And I want to express my appreciation to the Vice President of Academic Affairs, the Dean, the classified professionals in the healthcare unit, and all the faculty and staff who've worked with your students to help them get to this point. It takes a village, right? Sometimes we can do things by ourselves, but we can go really, really far if we do things together. And so, you know, a word always comes to mind when I'm talking to people who are in healthcare. I'm gonna reveal my age a little bit. I grew up watching Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, and I was one who always wanted to be his neighbor. But when talking about people who are helpers, he said this: when I was a boy and I would see scary things in the news, my mother would say to me, look for the helpers. You will always find people who are helping. And I want to thank all of you graduates for being willing, volunteering, standing up loud and proud and saying, I'm a helper. Because our world today needs a lot of helpers, and thank you for doing that. Have a great day.
Good afternoon. The pinning ceremony is a long honored tradition held by nursing schools all over the nation. I want to share with you the importance of the pinning ceremony and what the pin signifies. The teardrop shape is for compassion we hold for those in our care. Simplicity is for the dignity of the profession we represent. The eternal flame is a continuum of the two pivotal chapters of life, birth and death. The larger is life with its warmth and hope. Gold is for the quality of integrity and service to mankind. And of course, the college name we are proud of because it is where these students have learned their skills to serve humanity. The Nightingale lamp, which you see here, has been modified, representing the way concepts in nursing has changed and continues to change for better service to humanity. Similarly, we have seen nursing evolve as a profession throughout time. The nursing profession had its origins in the 18th and 19th centuries. Throughout the 18th century, most care occurred at home or in the Catholic Church and was provided by monks and nuns. Industrialization brought about the need for change as the 18th century ended and the 19th century began. Wars requiring women of many backgrounds to step into the role of nursing promoted a shift towards formal education for nurses. In the 1850s, Florence Nightingale's work in the Crimean War provided a foundation for this education. And in the 1860s, Dorothea Dix set standards for practice as the superintendent of the Army nurses, and that was in the Civil War. In the 1870s, the first United States nursing school based on Florence Nightingale's principles was founded. In the 1940s, the Cadet Nurse Corps was developed in response to World War II. This program allowed for accelerated nurse training in which women were quickly trained and sent to war. The program prevented the collapse of civilian nursing, ensuring nurses were available both on the battlefield and at home. In 2010, the Institute of Medicine advocated for a widening in the scope of practice for nurses. And throughout the 20th and 21st century, we have seen that what nurses can do independently has increased exponentially. In recent years, the resilience and adaptability of nursing was tested by the COVID pandemic. Nurses dealt with long hours, protective equipment shortages, and the stress of healthcare system in turmoil. They rose to the occasion, however, adapting to constant changes in care for their patients. Alongside them were the students that you see here today, who studied, as they were studying to become nurses, faithfully showed up and worked tirelessly with these nurses over the past year. Nursing is never stagnant, but it is a profession that matures and adapts to the changing times. As you can see, the students sitting before you today are attired in two different kinds of nurse uniforms, which reflects these characteristics. The students dressed in the traditional white uniform represent the forgers of the nursing profession, which began in the 18th and 19th century. Their traditional dress signifies the strength and endurance of women making their way into the profession of healthcare. The students dressed in maroon scrubs signify the inclusive and adapting environment of nursing in the 20th and 21st century. Please join me in a well-deserved round of applause for our graduates of 2022. Process, but before we do, traditionally we award the Rei Yoshida Memorial Scholarship to students who demonstrate outstanding academic and professional qualities. Normally there is one student that stands out among the others. This year it was difficult to identify just one student, and so we have selected two. Angelica Ochoa and Jessica Redmond.
Begin the pinning. Malena Ponce. Liliana Castro. Angie Ochoa. Joanne Almaguer. Sasha Mendezabel. Amanda Weston. Lily Mancia. Ariana Corbett. And this is Ariana's mother. And she's an ABC alumni as well. Teresa Villa. Steven Rivera. Alicia Guillory. Alan Gomez. Melissa Cortez.
Melissa.
Nathan Ingersoll.
All right, Nate. Woo-hoo! Woo-hoo!
Jessica Redman. Gilbert. Harry Bennett. Now we will do our traditional lamp lighting ceremony, which symbolizes us passing the torch literally to our new grads. The pledge will be led by Susie Snyder. Well, nurses, it's time for your nursing pledge, so please repeat after me. As a nurse dedicated to providing the highest quality care and services,
as a nurse,
I'll start later. As a nurse dedicated, to providing the highest quality care,
And services.
I solemnly pledge that I will consider the welfare of humanity and relief.
Of suffering my primary concerns.
Act in a compassionate and trustworthy manner. In all aspects of my care. Apply my knowledge.
Experience.
And skills. To the best of my ability.
To assure optimum outcomes.
For my patients. Exercise sound professional judgment. By legal and ethical requirements. Accept the lifelong obligation. To improve my professional knowledge.
And competence.
Promote.
Advocate for.
And strive.
To protect the health, safety, and rights
of the patient.
Of the patients.
With this pledge,
I accept
the duties,
I accept the duties,
and responsibilities,
and responsibilities,
that embody the nursing profession.
That embody the nursing profession.
I take this pledge voluntarily,
I take this pledge voluntarily,
with a full realization,
with a full realization,
of the responsibility,
of the responsibility,
with which,
I am entrusted by the public.
Thank you.
I have the pleasure of announcing Lily Mencia.
Very special. I speak for everyone when we didn't know exactly what we were getting into at all. There's been a lot of highs, a lot of lows, and imparting wisdom that I would like to say to the class and to myself, to remind myself, yes, is don't take yourself too seriously. Be careful. Do your patient rights when you give medications, yes. And this is a long road ahead of us, but we'll get there. And believing in yourself, as we've believed in each other this entire program, we've pulled each other out of the gutter, we've cleaned each other's patients, we've done everything for each other. I'm gonna have a little bit of separation anxiety, don't worry about it. But I truly believe in all of you. And I hope the NCLEX is as easy as I think it is. And I hope you guys do whatever you want in your career and have a good life.
Thanks.
So the next step is to study for the NCLEX and pass it the first time.
Yes.
We've trained you well. On behalf of the faculty, the staff, and administration, I'd like to thank you for coming today and tell you to be safe out there and celebrate these amazing people.
Thank you.